Now, one of the things that Reagan did so effectively in A Time for Choosing is he spoke in terms of stories. He spoke in terms of anecdotes. He used humor. He connected with people in a very real way. He made the point to your heart and to your brain. One of the most well-known segments was where he talks about a friend of his who was talking to a recent refugee from Cuba. And Reagan says this friend of his said to this Cuban refugee, "We don't know how lucky we are." And the Cuban responded, "How lucky you are. I had a place to escape to. Where do we go if America's no longer free?" Well, truth is timeless. And the choice that faced this country in the 1960s and the 1980s is the same choice that faces this country today. It's fundamentally a choice between more government and more freedom. And that's why the speech is called A Time for Choosing. As Reagan said elsewhere, every generation has to step up and defend freedom. It's not passed down in the bloodstream from one generation to the next. And that, A Time for Choosing, was really a call for people to stand up and defend freedom, not to just quietly see it slip away, not to quietly give away their liberties. There are times in life that are decision points. Our country is at a crisis right now. This is not a typical moment in politics. This is a time for choosing. If we keep going down this path, there will come a time of no return. And what Young America's Foundation is doing is highlighting that message, that choice, and highlighting it in particular to young people who have to understand this choice will matter for their entire lives. This choice is about what kind of future every young man and every young woman in this country has. Do you have a future that has characterized the United States for centuries? A future where anybody with nothing can achieve anything. That's our legacy. But that is being imperiled by these failed economic policies. Today, just like in the 1960s, just like in 1980, today is a time for choosing.